These interviews will form part of our Mary Portas second round bid. We hope to clearly illustrate how Dartmouth will benefit hugely from winning this grant.
On the surface, you may think Dartmouth looks as though it's a flourishing town, but underneath the surface, the salary levels are very low, the jobs are seasonal. Many people here struggle to find work during the winter, so the whole town is struggling economically.
The challenges we find are the seasonality is a very big part of it, where we have peaks and troughs. So the summers are very, very busy, and then the winters are considerably quieter. You just have to really try and do as much as you can in the summer, but that period is affected by weather, as we've seen this year.
People come here every year and come in and tell me how wonderful it is to be back and how they wish they just lived here, because the ambience of the whole town is just so charming. The fact that we are all small independents is definitely in our favour. The kind of tourists we get here come from larger cities and bigger towns.
And we believe there is a unique opportunity just to use the internet to try and promote the town and to sell the town as a destination for people to come to. So although the internet is having an impact on town centres negatively, it can be used positively to support town centres as well. And we want to prove that with Portas money.
We're very much at the end of the line when it comes to South Devon. So it's about attracting people to come here, really showing ourselves off as a beautiful town.
There are many businesses in Dartmouth, including mine, which you can see behind, which make use of the internet to support their trade, to make up for the fact that less visitors are coming here. There are at least three or four businesses with very strong internet presences. But there are lots of businesses that don't have that possibility. So we feel that using the internet to promote those businesses and to bring people actually into the town will make a big difference to them.
I certainly wouldn't. If I go away, I don't go away very often because the life of a restaurateur is very busy. But when I do, I always check on the web to see where I'm going, to check out what's going to be on, what's available in the towns I'm going. So I think for Dartmouth, it's really important for us to promote the town for all its assets, the fantastic food, the shops, the attractions, all those kind of things, so people can, you know, plan a nice weekend away or a nice, you know, 2-day stay midweek. It's a fantastic destination with so many good things happening, going on, events, all those kind of things. You know, we need a really good web presence to promote Dartmouth as a town for all seasons and a fantastic place to shop, eat and enjoy.
Sarah, do you think having a marketing team in Dartmouth would help promote Dartmouth to a much wider region?
I think it is crucial that Dartmouth has a marketing team, or even a marketing one person to start with that builds into a team. We've got such a fantastic product here of Dartmouth. It needs pushing. We want people in London, when they're walking in the tube stations, to see what we've got to offer here. We want people, when they're looking on the internet, to see this as a destination for food, for great scenery, for retail. And we just cannot, as small businesses, afford to do the work ourselves. We need some assistance to do it.
I think a marketing team would be a good idea, because they'd be able to show Dartmouth off to its best potential and really get the town out there throughout the country and also hopefully into Europe as well.
This is very difficult times that we're in now, and we're all struggling to try and make a profit from our businesses, which is very difficult. The specific challenge is getting that footfall through the shop door. Also, we need to attract more people to the town with better marketing of the town.
Maybe there should be some kind of appointed group that, you know, promotes Dartmouth as a business, as a place to make for.
The town would definitely, you know, benefit from a marketing team that was marketing purely Dartmouth as a venue to come and look at the wealth of different independent shops we've got, and obviously the historical beauty of the town.
What a virtual Dartmouth presence would allow you to do would be to describe the range of services and products that are available in Dartmouth, and most importantly to differentiate those services by imposing some of the personality of the people that sell the product. So it's an independent shop and a real owner, as opposed to this is just another high street shop, you know, 50 of them, 200 of them around the country. A virtual town centre would be an invaluable way of people preparing for the town to, you know, dress itself up and show its personality and its diversity.
We have this great need to go beneath the veneer of what looks wonderful and actually look at the concerns which traders have. I think it's important that if people can help us and resource us, we have the skills, but we just need that extra energy to support our future, our vision. It's very difficult. Dartmouth is not a town on a main line to anywhere. You deliberately have to come to Dartmouth, so we have to market ourselves.
We need investment to help us to make a difference here and do something about it.
If we can get extra resources, I think not only will it prove the point that funding like yours will enable us to get better, we'll actually improve the quality of life for visitors and, more importantly, those businesses who actually thrive on the town if they possibly can with additional resources. Thank you.